This match is brought to you by Two Tides Cottage. Enjoy a relaxing break overlooking the stunning scenery of Loo in Cornwall at Two Tides Cottage. This highly rated, spacious holiday home features three bedrooms, a TV, fully equipped kitchen, dishwasher and an oven, plenty of seating and a fireplace. Call the number on screen and start planning your perfect trip today. If you want to sponsor our highlights package and keep them going throughout the season, make sure to get in touch and find out how.
Let's go. Yeah. Wondered why I'm grey. Fabulous result for the team, but what's gone on in the last three games, and again to go down to 10 men again is so tough for the players that are left out on the pitch, and you know we've got to make sure that we're 11 at the end of a game. But you know, to score five goals at home, okay, disappointed to let three in, but. I think the main thing today was the 3 points.
So yeah, as I mentioned, the first 3 points of the season, must be buzzing for that.
Oh, I'm absolutely delighted for the players in there. They've worked really hard the first three games. You know, especially on Tuesday down at Merthyr, we were under the cosh for long spells, but they dug in and conceded a goal in 7 minutes of injury time. So today it was nice to get a victory, and you know, I think it's. One thing I always know is that when you've had a good win at home, scored a few goals, you don't go backwards, you go forwards. And, you know, without looking at the league table at the moment, I'd say we'd be up one or two spots, which is what you're looking to do.
So about going forwards, you've had three red cards in the last three matches. How are we looking at the discipline going forwards?
Oh, it's so... I mean, like today, it's difficult to know what Jack's done. He's apologised in the dressing room. But it's, you know, when you get a booking, you just got to be very, very careful. And you know, I thought their three were so lucky to stay on the pitch. You know, and you want things to be the same for both sides. But you know, to me today, that the referee didn't do his job.
About two goals from Carol Salmon, going to assist from Niall. But who was your personal man of match out on the pitch today?
I thought Carlo Garside had a real good game. I thought he was tenacious when we didn't have the ball, and you know, he kept us in good possession. And I enjoyed watching him because we haven't played him at right back before. So I thought he did a sterling job there.
Thank you, Martin.
Cheers,
Plymouth Parkway next. Looking forward to the bank holiday fixture.
Yeah, it's always one local derby. It's always you always look forward to, and you know, I don't know how they got on today, but whatever the result, it's always a tough game against them, and you know, they've had a not such a good start along with us before today, so it's going to be a good game to come and watch.
I guess expecting the fans to make a lot of noise.
Yeah, I'd like to think we get a good crowd in and get behind the team. One thing they're giving at the moment, they're giving their all out on the pitch, and you know, they deserve, you know, people to come in and get behind them, because I think it's nothing better than having a home side get behind the side and really cheer them on.
Right.
I thought we started off pretty well, going 1-0 up, and then we made it hard for ourselves again, going in half time 1-1. I think we keep conceding too many goals, but I thought second half we came out, done very well, got it to 3-1. Then to 4-2, and I think we got a man sent off again, which keeps happening. We make it harder for ourselves again, but end result 5-3, first 3 points, so good game.
Okay, and obviously two more goals to add to your tally for the season. You must be glad to start racking up the goals.
Yeah. That was like my aim at the start of the season. Just obviously I was here at the end of last season, played 8 games, didn't really get on the score sheet at all really. So I spoke to Gaffer before the season, that was like my aim, to just have more shots, got on the score sheet more, and yeah, three goals so in the last four games, so it's alright.
So obviously, you know, going into next week's game against Beaconsfield, and then obviously Parkview on Monday, hopefully we'll see some more goals from you.
Yeah, hopefully.
And obviously some more points on the board as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, yeah, fingers crossed.
Lovely stuff, thank you.
No, we're just giving bad goals away. Bad goals away, we can't do it at this level. We can't do it at any level, but just get punished, don't you? You get punished. Five goals today, three goals away from home. We looked alright going forward, defensively, poor. Just bad goals, bad day, just not good enough.
What,
nowhere near it.
What have you said to the lads in the changing room?
A few untruths. You know, can't feel sorry for ourselves. We can't live on last year and getting last gone. Do you know what I mean? We're at this level now, and we got to compete. We got to fight. We knew it was going to be hard, but nowhere near good enough. Nowhere near it.
Challenging start of the season. Yeah. Is there any optimism you can give to the fans going forward?
Yeah, of course. Always optimism. We've got 38 games to play. Still, loads of time, but we've got to learn. We've got to man up. We've got to be better than what we're showing, because teams are just rolling over us, aren't they? It's just not good enough.
They went down to 10 men, but 4-1. Do you think the game was already gone at that point?
Yeah. Come out at half time and they score within 30 seconds of the second half, and then they score another three in 15 minutes, wherever it is. You can't do that. You can't do that. You know what I mean? You can't. Yeah, we're better against. Well, they scored with 10 men, didn't they? So, you know, but yeah, we scored, and we had chances to score more goals, but you can't. Can't give teams five goals and defend like we do. It's not good enough. But they've got to learn quick. We've got a big week this week. We've got Basingstoke Saturday, Hungerford Monday. You know, it don't get any easier. But we're not going to shirk it. I'm not going to shirk it. But you know, little Robbie Gallagher come on today. Brilliant when he come on. Runs, works, gets fouled, gets kicked, get everything. But don't moan. Just get some of it. Mm. It's just like. It's frustrating, very frustrating.
Thank you. Oh! Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. 1, 8, 4, 8, 6, And I have the winning of the Matt Brown White in the stand.
Thank you. Oh! Thank you. Come on! Come on! 212.
Oh!
Come on. Thank you. company, we have given a round of the match to Sweden's number 11, Dan Cameron.
Number 9, Adam Smith. Five all.
Let's go!
Oh my god!
Ben Foster's not even having a good match. You can see this five every